Washington MP.
Obviously, 20 world leaders could be here to hear in the square, to hear that song and to see this crowd.
Yeah.
I've got a message for all 20 world leaders who are gathering in London. There will be no justice in the world, and there will be no peace in the Middle East without a free and independent Palestine alongside Israel. And there will be no independent Palestine unless they make it happen. What we've seen what happens if you leave it to the Israelis. They launched a ferocious and inhumane attack on Gaza, as far as I could see, just to help them win an election. They killed 1,500 Gazans, nearly all civilians, and they devastated thousands of homes. I went there and I saw it myself with other MPs in February, just to gain 3 points in the opinion polls. And then they magically stopped just a few days before President Obama's inauguration. We've heard it from the testimony of Israeli soldiers in the military college, that they were sent there with orders to clear houses by shooting without warning, because the lives of Palestinians were, in the words of one soldier, very, very less important than the lives of Israelis. We now have an Israeli Prime Minister who doesn't want peace talks, and we have an Israeli Foreign Minister who lives in an illegal settlement in the West Bank.
Yes.
We know they don't want peace because they are still building a wall, they are still building more checkpoints in the West Bank, they are still expanding settlements in the West Bank. Don't expect anything from them. The only people who can deliver peace are the ones who are sitting down to dinner, to a Jamie Oliver dinner tonight. And the only way that they can do it is by imposing a cost on the Israelis if they refuse to negotiate peace. So I say to them, stop giving the Israelis preferential tariffs. Suspend the EU-Israel trade agreement. Reimpose the arms embargo. Investigate the war crimes. And I don't mean an Israeli Defence Force investigation. And I don't mean just the United Nations investigation of the damage to the UN compound. I mean a United Nations Security Council sanctioned investigative report that can take action and force the Israelis to cooperate. So, President Obama, you owe it to the children of Gaza, not only the 400 who died, but also the hundreds who were injured and who face lives devoid of all hope, to bring Israel, kicking and screaming if need be, to the negotiating table. Thank you.
Thanks, Andy.